Hi guys, in this tutorial I would like to talk about shaders. We're gonna start with these generalities. So first of all, we got three type of shaders. We got the surface type, the volume type, and the displacement type. In this different type, we got a couple of shaders. We got the surface, and surface 2 was gonna be the generality shader that we are gonna use for the surfacing. And most of the time when I'm gonna talk about the surface, I'm gonna talk about the surface 2. In fact, that's the only one that we're gonna use, the surface 1. It's just a legacy shader for older user of Guerilla. And we got a couple of specific one. There is the air and this new version, the air 2, which is kind of crazy. And we got specific shader also for getting surfacing without any interaction with light. That's his surface shader. It's gonna give you a matte effect that if you wanna use for any kind of like compositing to use as a matte. But we see that we got different way of exporting IDs. We got a curve one, which is kind of a super old one shader for curves. And we got the I and I2, which is a super specific shader. I've got a tutorial about this one, about the a rig that you can create for Maya and how to use that into the shader. So we're not gonna talk that much about this one. And for the volume, we got two different families, the volume and volume 2. Same case, volume 1 is legacy, volume 2 is a new version, and absorption 1. And last but not least, the displacement family, which we got the displacement traditional one, standard one, vector displacement that we not talk that much. But it uses an XYZ image, an RGB in fact, image to displace in three direction as the difference between the basic displacement. And we got a volume displacement specific one. So how to manipulate these three types? So first of all, I've got a really basic scene that's just a sphere and two dice distant light that you can see right there in my perspective view. So first of all, I'm going to create a surface 2 and I'm going to connect it, I'm going to render it, and as you can see, it's set by default to surface, it's more this surface. So in fact, that's the type I was talking about. As you can see, you can set some directly the type of, but we're not going to touch that. We're going to see later how to use that to override some settings. So in the shader, I'm going to change basically the color of my diffuse, and it's going to turn like reddish one. Okay. I've got some subdivision or artifacts. So I'm going to create an attributes node. And okay, so let's go to subdivision. Let's add some level of subdivision, smooth the sphere, and we're going to get kind of closer perfect sphere. Okay. So that's the surface one. I'm gonna remove the shader and I'm gonna use a volume one. Beam, I'm gonna connect it, render it. Okay, so what's the issues? It's in fact selecting the sphere. The sphere is not shaded by a volume. In fact, it's shaded by a volume, but not really. If we select the sphere, you can see that the sphere is going through two paths. It's going through the this path because it's called by the alt tag, and as you can see, it's called also by the sphere path. So that makes sense. That's explained what we got this look of occlude. Well, it's not it's occlude, the volume inside the sphere, so that's why it's occlude. But in fact, that's why we got the Lurbersian kind of a shader. In fact, if I wanna override this, I've got two solutions. First of all, I can go to my merge and change my merging by replace. So that's mean that everything that's gone with this branch is gonna be replaced. and my shading, my object is shading volume. So that's the first case. Second case, I can do something else. In fact, what happened, it's that this object, it's also a volume and also a sphere. It also shaped by a surface and also by a, volume. How I can know that? If I select the object and I go to shading, if I go to surface, I can see that it's shaded by the surface. But if I go to volume, as you can see, it's shaded also by the volume. So how I can reveal something like that? It can be super fun to connect this shader instead that we're gonna turn it into a glass, like a glass with specularity in glass. And now, as you can see, we got a glass ball with volume inside of it. So we're mixing the two of them. And we're gonna add the third one, which is the displacement node. Material displacement, and I'm gonna add the last one. I'm gonna create a super simple cloud map. So let's say that we're gonna add some octaves, and let's say 6 is gonna be enough. We got subdivision, we're gonna add one level of subdivision, and we're gonna render it with adding some displacement. So I can add displacement at a couple of levels. I can add displacement at a level, but I can also drive the displacement into my displacement node. It depends on the way you wanna work with. So I'm gonna add displacement, I'm gonna add something super tiny, that one, and as you can see, start to displace the surface. So let's say 0.2, let's go for something crazier. Okay, that's it. So as you can see, I can mix the three of them, but I can drive it in a different way. So let's go back to my first case when I was using that this way. And I don't want to use the merge one. I don't want to change the merge because I don't know what kind I've got in this branch. And maybe I don't want to replace the world branch by all the parameters. I want to mix the two branch together. What I can do, it's getting my volume node and switching it to material. What does it mean? It means that right now, my volume shader is gonna draw all the three types and is gonna replacing all the three types at a time. So right now, the material of the node, of this sphere, sorry, it's a volume, it's nothing else. So because it's driving all the material away. So material means the parent of all the three types. So if you set to material, you're overriding all the aspects of the shading with this specific shader.